Mounting the bearing caps involves using this big long drill, which needs clearance grooves made in the bosses. Here. The ball end mills that I have are either too small or too large, so CNC to the rescue, and I made a profile for the grooves to use the 16th inch ball end mill in using Fusion 360. So we're back to the jig that mounts the frame, and then we cut the grooves out using two passes. The first roughing pass is fairly quick, and then the smoothing pass is just really silly. It's just cutting in air most of the time. I don't really know what it was doing, but it's a one-off, so it doesn't really matter. Seems to line up nicely. The plan is to mount them in place with superglue and then drill, and we already have the center drills in place on the bearing caps. So using some math and feeler gauges and a V-block and some other bits and bobs, I was able to get the X dimension set accurately, and the idea is to have the Y dimension aesthetically central, because these are in fact meant to be like castings. And gluing in with a super glue, this is not the right super glue. This is the quick setting stuff, which meant that as soon as I put the thing down, it stuck in place. And usually that wasn't quite the right place yet. This is not the final attempt. It took me about 10 attempts altogether to get both bearing caps in a satisfactory location. Very accurate in X and good enough in Y. If you're enjoying this series, please click the like button or subscribe or both, and leave some comments or questions below, and I will try and answer them as soon as I can. I apologize for the ring on finger here. Forgot to take it off. Never wear jewelry when working with machine tools. This is my little manual press down little tiny chuck for using small drills. In this case, however, something went wrong. I did get the first hole drilled. It seemed to go fine. And on the way over to the second one, I did this, which might be where the drill broke. And when I went to drill the second hole, it wasn't drilling. However, a little bit of drill sharpening managed to get it functional. Not great at sharpening drills, but got it going, and I got all four holes drilled successfully. Tapping these tiny, teeny holes is a challenge. I'm using a bearing cap as a tapping guide and needle nose pliers to actually turn the tap, because there is no way to get this in. I was very lucky I didn't have to shorten the tap shank, but it just cleared the casting. And the end result is two bearing caps that are mounted with little tiny screws. These are 256, and there's extra metal for machining off later, which will be the next process. And then we will drill a hole in the middle for the crankshaft. Yay!